Hi, I'm Bob Berry, and today we are going to talk about the touch potential and step potential hazards that may occur when operating cranes in the proximity of energized utilities. First, the best way to avoid these hazards is to follow the proper procedures for working near power lines. However, if contact with an energized utility does occur, it is equally important to know how to respond and avoid becoming a fatality. When a crane makes contact with an energized line, the machine and immediate area nearby becomes energized by potential energy. This energy is released due to grounding when a person touches the machine or steps into the immediate area, causing severe electric shock and fatalities. To avoid touch potential, never approach a crane or other equipment that has made contact with an energized power line. You may not see sparks, or even if the power cuts off, power lines may cycle back on several times when a fault occurs prior to shutting off. To avoid step potential, always stay far away from the area immediately near a crane that has made contact with live power. Electricity conducted to the ground by the equipment creates zones of unequal voltage. As a person approaches the equipment, stepping between these invisible electrified zones causes the stored energy to pass through the body and find equilibrium, shocking and killing the worker. A common mistake that often occurs after the equipment makes contact with a power line, workers investigating or attempting to rescue others also get electrocuted and killed, causing multiple fatalities. Even if you see another worker electrocuted, it is important to resist the instinct to run to their rescue. Always contact qualified emergency rescue services to handle the situation safely and avoid additional fatalities. In most cases, the operator in the crane will not experience any electric shock and should stay inside the cab until help arrives. Attempting to exit the crane creates a serious step potential hazard. Only attempt to exit the crane if other life-threatening hazards such as fire present an immediate risk and staying in the cab is no longer a safe option. To exit the crane, jump with both feet together, landing on both feet. Shuffle to safety, being careful not to separate your feet or take a full step until a safe distance has been reached. Also, as a reminder, always be extra mindful of surroundings when working near power lines. Electricity often causes life-threatening injuries and requires extreme caution to work safely. And remember, proper planning, awareness of surroundings, and good communication always makes for a safe lift. Look for our next Sims Crane Minute coming soon.